So is showing the NP-completeness of a problem always so involved with playing around with strange constructions such as, you know, weird networks? Well, the answer is in a way yes. Showing NP-completeness can often involve playing around a lot and some gory details in the proofs. So even today, there are still scientific papers being published that basically just show the NP-completeness of a certain problem or set of problems. So it's not an easy task. But luckily, there's a whole arsenal of known NP-complete problems out there, which I'm now going to show you. If you go on Wikipedia, for example, there's a whole list of NP-complete problems from graph theory, network design, sets and partitions, and so on and so on. So for most practical problems that you'll encounter, either they have already been shown to be NP-complete, or they will likely be very similar to one or more of these problems for which we already know that they are NP-complete. In this case, similarity is a good thing, because similarity means that your reductions will in most cases be either much easier than what we have just seen with shortest tour, or at least if you then look at the NP-completeness proofs for those problems, they might give you techniques and ideas for performing the reduction that you're looking for. The foundation for this library was laid by a computer scientist called Richard Karp, who in 1972 showed 21 different problems to be NP-complete. And that was basically the starting point for this huge list of thousands of NP-complete problems. Now let's see if you already have an intuition which NP-complete problems would be most useful to show the NP-completeness of other problems. So let's say you encounter a number of problems. One problem will deal with clustering, or finding large groups of related objects. Or you would encounter a problem that deals with covering a set of objects as efficiently as possible. So you have to select a few objects that in some way observe, or, you know, covering is a good term, other objects in the set. Or you could encounter a problem that in some way deals with optimizing pathways. So getting from one point to another point, but there are a few constraints of here that you have to meet. So here's covering. Here you're trying to find close groups of related objects. Finally, you could deal with a problem that is about diversification. So large groups of independent objects don't have anything to do with each other. And finally, something else. Now you already know 5 NP-complete problems. You know shortest tour, you know vertex cover, you know set, independent set, and click. Now, what I would like to know from you is if you encounter a problem that basically arises in one of these 5 situations here, which of these problems here, for which we know that they are NP-complete, would be your best bet for proving a problem that falls into one of these categories here is NP-complete? So basically using this as a basis for a reduction. So these are numbered, and you can enter your numbers for the ones that you think match best in these circles here.